ahead may be unknown, as I brave the unseen road, God, go with me. Every hidden sacrifice through the watches of the night, God, go with me. Through it all I know I am not alone. I am fearless in your presence. You're all around me, in my weakness. You are strongest, you surround me, you surround me. No fear in the crashing waves, no fear when the cost is great, no fear in the midnight hour, you've given me a spirit of power. No fear in the crashing waves, no fear when the cost is great, no fear in the midnight hour, you've given me a spirit of power, of power.
About the greatest showman in heaven and earth. Step right up! I have another story that will amaze you, full of wonders that will astound you. Sherry? What have you got yourself into today?
Don't call me Sherry, call me Ellie the Extraordinary Escape Artist.
Are you okay? Why are you wrapped up in chains?
Well, Edward the Exceptional Escape Artist is going on holiday next week to visit his mom in Ecuador, and he suggested I might want to fill in for him while he's away. After breakfast this morning, he put me in these chains.
After breakfast? But Sherry, it is after dinner. You've been trapped in this all day?
Yes, I have. All I can say that it was a good thing I decided to go with that super big breakfast special this morning, or I'd be fainting from hunger right now. I didn't really want to ask for help, but as you can see, I'm really stuck.
Well, I know someone else who was stuck in chains and had no way of escape.
Really? What did they do? Maybe I could borrow their technique.
Well, it was Peter, one of Jesus' special friends. He had been telling everyone about Jesus, how he lived and died and was alive again. Some people didn't like what Peter was doing. A king named Herod put him in prison. The king ordered that Peter be put in chains and that there was to be a guard on either side of him, watching so he couldn't escape.
Whoa, sure sounds like he was in a sticky situation.
Not only that, King Herod also ordered guards to stand watch outside the prison doors. Altogether, there were 16 soldiers guarding him to make sure he wouldn't be able to escape.
Well, he's clearly not going to be able to give me any tips on how to get out of my chains. He was probably stuck until he died of starvation.
Actually, that is not what happened. Remember, Sherry, God can provide a way when there seems to be no way.
Oh, okay, but what could he possibly do? I mean, it sounds like Peter was dressed up tighter than a turkey stuffed onto Thanksgiving.
I know it may look bad, but Romans 8 verse 28 tells that for those who love God, all things work together for good.
Well, I don't know, Shan. Doesn't sound too good to me. It sounds impossible.
Well, fortunately for us, our God is the God of the impossible. God sent an angel to help Peter escape. You can read the whole story in the Bible. It is in the book of Acts, chapter 12. It is one of my favorite things God has done. In fact, the book of Acts is filled with all sorts of amazing feats of bravery and sacrifice and miracles that God did for and through people who loved him.
Well, I would love to go and read more in my Bible about it, but I'm a little bit tied up right now.
Well, I know I'm not a heavenly angel, but sometimes God uses people instead of angels when he wants to help someone. Abracadabra, ella peanut butter sandwich!
Thank you, Sherry! I'm free, thank you!
You're very welcome, Sherry.
Well, I don't think I want to see these ever again. See you later.
Bye, Sherry. Are any of you in a situation that seems impossible? If so, I bet you're glad to learn today that God can provide a way when there seems to be no way. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you that nothing is too difficult for you. Thank you that you care for me and that you can make a way when there seems to be no way. Help me to trust you to work everything out for the good. Amen. Wasn't Peter's rescue truly outstanding, boys and girls? Let's see if you can say with me the other incredible things we learn for people who give their lives to Jesus. First, we learn that when we give our lives to Jesus, we don't have to be afraid. That means we don't ever have to live in fear. Then we discovered that when we give our lives to Jesus, we can be certain that God is always with us. Next, we learned the wonderful truth that when we give our lives to Jesus, he will give us the strength we need to do what he asks. And today, we learned that when we give our lives to Jesus, God can provide a way when there seems to be no way. Incredible! I'm so glad that God is so great and mighty. You all got your show packs ready? Today's craft, we're going to make something that is going to be Peter in prison, okay? But the angel is with him, so you'll need your piece of cardstock, to find your small craft sticks. Some glue. Your angel. And Peter. Your crayons. Your scripture. As well as your glue stick. And when you have all that, you can pack your craft pack and put it aside. So the first thing you're going to do is, we are going to color in Peter and the angel. So with your crayons, have fun and be creative. Chosen to leave my angel's body white and made the wings yellow to represent gold wings. Then I'm going to color in Peter. Has a beard and a mustache. Okay friends, so I have my angel and I have Peter. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to stick Peter and the angel onto our piece of cardstock. So with your glue stick, when you stick them down, don't put them too far apart from each other because we're going to use our craft sticks to go around them as well as in front of them. So I have Peter and the angel stuck down, and now I'm going to take my craft sticks and I'm going to put a little bit of glue along to open it. Don't squeeze your bottle too hard because you don't need too much glue. And you're going to do one across the top. That. going down each side. And then friends, you will have four cross sticks left, and these are going to be the bars of the prism. So they go in the middle. And you just need to put glue on the top and on the bottom. Make glue onto the top and bottom sticks. Push them down, hold them tight, so they can stick. And there's Peter and the angel. And our last thing we're going to do is we're going to cut out our scripture for today. So day four. Help if you need to with the scissors. Cut the scripture, and then you can decide where you would like to stick it. I think I did across the top. So Romans 8 is 28. Friends, that's our craft for today.